It was a very interesting day. I was booked on Serene Airlines at 11 o'clock and the unfortunate flight, PIA was at 1 o'clock. I opted to fly on PIA primarily because I have a huge issue getting up early. But interestingly, that day only, I actually got up much ahead of my usual time. My protocol guy told me that I don't have to be at the airport before 45 minutes, but I reached the airport 1.5 hours earlier than the flight. I am notorious in terms of, you know, getting late to the airports. Not very proud of that, but that's how I am. Interestingly enough, the flight also took off early that day. The flight was very smooth, but when it tried to land on Karachi airport the first time, there was one bump, and then there was a second bump, and then there was a third bump at the landing. So there were three times that the engine touched the runway. By the time you could have reacted or thought about anything, the flight actually took back up again in the air. Since I was on the first seat, I don't know what was happening in the rest of the cabin, but I could see that the air hostesses were panicking. They started reciting Quranic verses. Few minutes later, a steward also came and sat right next to me across the aisle, and he also seemed panicked. And then the plane took back up, and then it took a round, and when it was coming back again, there was a kind of a jerk. Since I was in the first seat, I could see the cockpit door opening. I could see from the windscreen, it appeared that the plane was nosediving. And at that time, maybe half a minute, 30 seconds ahead of the crash, I realized that the plane is crashing. And it seems that, you know, we will not be able to avert this unfortunate situation. I spoke to myself and I asked my God, so the plane is crashing and I'm dying. So I got this voice internally from inside. My God tells me that, no, it's not the time. You're not dying. And then I asked him again. I said, God, but it's inevitable. It cannot be avoided. It's crashing. He said, yes, the plane is crashing. It's not your time. And by the time this whole conversation was going on, the entire life of mine was in front of me like on a canvas. As expected, the plane crashed. And I could see that the plane was wobbling. When I fainted, I just passed out. And then when I got the consciousness, I was already been rescued. You know, people were already taking me out of the rebels. That tough period, I don't remember at all. These are all third-party account what happened. I really have no recollection of what actually happened. Some people say that my seat just fell off. It fell on the rooftop and then from there to the car bonnet. And there were people sitting in the car. And then those people rescued me and took me out. I don't know how I got that consciousness. Probably because my hand was hurting. My hand is broken, by the way. It still is. I've just got my bone grafting done. So they've taken the bone out from my hip and put it in there. And all my ligaments are broken. So my leg was broken. And my back is burnt. I still get the medication for it. The moment I was put in the ambulance, my first reaction was, what happened to the rest of the passengers? And they told me they don't know. All they know is that the plane has crashed on a habitat and they're here to rescue people. And I'm the first one who's being rescued. And when they took me to the hospital, my first question again at the hospital was about the other passengers. And again, they told me that they are not aware of anybody. They don't know what's going on. The other family members were very, very upset. I've been told, except for my father. My father was the only one who was very stable. And he had that conviction like me that everything will be okay and I'll be fine. I cannot live with the fear that I can't do a thing. And I realized that, you know, I have to get over this fear. Like anybody else, I was also very fearful of not traveling by air, and particularly on PIA, and not on the same flight. It's actually the same flight which actually crashed here, which goes back to Lahore, and I was going back on the same flight. Lucky for me, when the plane crashed, I had fainted. So therefore, I don't have those horrible memories of the crash as such, as compared to anybody else who would have faced that crunch period also. During the crash as well. I hadn't gone through that, so my capacity of taking risk was much higher than anybody else's who would have experienced a similar accident. And I think it's very important for me that I fly the same airline, I go on the same flight, I sit on the same seat, and I get over that fear myself. I'm extremely proud of my staff and my work colleagues. They have been absolutely exceptional. And they stood by me like a rock. So two of them, actually, they decided will travel with me. Before the takeoff, I thought that, you know, probably I will have a tough time and the flight will reach the peak. But no, it was a normal feeling. The part that probably bothers me is the landing part when we come closer to the ground and we come close to the habitat. So as the time is progressing, as I'm getting more flights and all, that fear is actually going away and it's getting normalized.